It's their desire for God that's pushing them to do that, and not just a religious thing. Mm-hmm. But I just look at that and I think, God, you know. And Brother Daniel had something on his Facebook the other day. He said, "Wouldn't it be great if adults would go after God the way kids hunt Easter eggs?" Isn't that good? Oh, the hunger, thirst after God. That's what Joshua was talking about. Sanctify yourselves. Prepare yourselves. Let's go. We're going across. Nobody talked about it. It's too much. They're too big. We're grasshoppers in their sight. We can't make it. Nobody said that.
Hallelujah.
And I think part of that reason was because Joshua wasn't going to put up with it. He didn't give them room to say it. And guess what? Pastor Scott won't give you room to say it either.
Man.
If you say, "Well, Pastor, I just don't think we should turn the church around." Thank you for your input. I appreciate that. And okay. But it's, now that the thing that we have to do is to individually, before this church can ever corporately go to this new place, place that we've never been before, is for us as individuals to step into a place we've never been before.
Some of us,
it's going to be deeper worship. Some have already done that. It was a thrill today to see people up here at the front,
man,
you know, worshiping and just going after it. You know, it's a thrill. And I know it thrills God tremendously.
Man.
But that's that hunger and that thirst, just to, for some of you to step out of the comfort zone, maybe with praise and worship or your prayer life or just a commitment to something that you've never committed to before. And God is calling us as individuals to that, so that corporately this church can go on. And 50 years from now, people go walk in and go, wow. And they're going to see thousands of souls that have been saved and won to the Lord. And they're going to go to a wall and look and say, "Man, look at all these missionaries they got all over the world. Man, look at all these evangelists they sent out from here. Look at all this stuff. Look at what they do for this community. They're the biggest contributors to whenever they have problems and hurricanes and stuff. This church gives more than anybody does."
Amen.
That's a great testimony, and God is calling us to that testimony.
Right.
Crossroads Chapel.
Right. That's right.
You and I, individually as a people, that we can take and shape up this town, this region, and see God. See God taking His rightful place.
Yes, amen.
God is calling us to a new place. God is calling us. I want to just share something quickly because I'm gonna close. But I know that in my personal life, there was a time that I got hurt by people. Not by God, but by people in a church. And I mean hurt, really, really hurt. And they attacked my family, and that was tough. I didn't have a gun. It's a good thing I didn't. But I remember getting to a place, and I remember walking, sometimes by myself, just walking, and that just festering in me. And I'm like, "Man, God, I will never, ever, ever again in my life allow myself to be that vulnerable and allow myself to be that open to be hurt like that again. I'll never do that, God. And if that means that I can't fulfill everything that you called me to do, that's the way it is. I'll try to be satisfied with the little bit I can get by with." And whenever I came to that place, one of the things that I didn't want to do is I did not want to go past those memorial places.
Huh.
You know why? Because then I had to go back and say, "This is what God did when there was an obstacle. When the river was at flood stage, when you didn't think you could make it at all, God was there. See, I didn't want to go by those memorial places. So man, I would go miles and miles and miles out of my way to keep from going past those memorials. And God just finally came to me and said, Johnny, I'm not done with you. And there's something that I want you to do. But you got to do it my way. And I said, well, God, you know, that spiritual burger thing is kind of nice. You know? Still have my burger in heaven my way. And God said, no, this is it. And I came to a place to where I finally just said, God, okay, here I am. And now I'm walking past memorials, and I'm looking, I'm like, God, you are so good. And my faith is being built up a little bit. I'm going past another memorial. And God is bringing me along. But folks, today, honestly, with all sincerity, today is May the 1st of 2011. Almost said 1911. We're really going back. I ain't born yet. But this May 1st, 2011, let this be a day, today, right now, where you say, God, okay, I'm ready. I'm ready.
Amen.
Yes.
And God is calling us today to that place of purification, sanctification, consecration. He's calling us, come on, step out of that comfort zone. Step into what I have for you. Get rid of all the baggage. Get rid of all the you can'ts. And realize that I can. That's what God is saying to us. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any other. That's our God. And he loves us.
Amen.
He has called us to a good work. To a good thing. And there are people that we're going to touch their lives. We're going to do all out blitz on hell and knock its gates down and drag people to kingdom, to the kingdom of God. We're going to do that. We're going to see the power of God manifested in this church and in this community and in our lives. But right now, what I'd really like for you to do, Ryan, if you what I'd like for you to do is just want to give you a challenge today. Now, if you are wanting to say today to God, Lord, I recognize I'm at a new place. This church is at a new place. I want to go on. I'm determined. I'm going to go on. I'm going to fulfill what you called me to. No matter what, God, I'm stepping out of those comfort zones. God, I'm doing the things that you want me to do. I'm stepping forward and I'm declaring today that I will fulfill all the destiny that you have for me. And I want you, if that's you today, and you are going to receive that fully, I want you to come, because I want to pray with you. And just as by coming, you're just making a commitment saying, Lord, I'm dedicating, I'm committing myself to this fully and completely. I'm purifying myself, consecrating myself, sanctifying myself, setting myself apart for this work, to cross this Jordan, to get to the other side, and to recognize.
Bless him, Lord.
This is a place of victory.
Bless him, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just come on up. If today you're making that commitment, if you're going to renew a commitment to the Lord, come on. Praise you, Lord.